Hello everyone and welcome back to a brand new video. If you're new here, my name is Jazlyn and if you're a returning subscriber, welcome back. Today I am going to be doing a tag video. We're just going to switch it up, have a little bit of fun, still on the topic of luxury fashion, but this could also be a bit of a learning opportunity for you as well because, as you know, the tag is the top three items that I purchased this year of 2020, plus one regret. And I was tagged by Amaya Lynx. If you guys don't know Amaya Lynx, she is a YouTuber in the UK. Her channel is very refreshing. I really love watching her videos. She does a lot on luxury fashion. She has a lot of videos on Hermès, if you guys are very interested in that brand. She also keeps it really real, and she's in her early 40s. So she has a lot of very practical advice to give to, you know, viewers of kind of the same age category, to other women, and to people who are younger as well. So I really like watching her videos. I mean, I learn quite a bit and I get some perspective on topics other than luxury. So if you guys haven't checked out her channel, you should. She's aiming to get to 5,000 subscribers. She's actually almost there, so you don't need my endorsement. But she is apparently going to be doing a Hermès giveaway in, you know, pretty soon when she hits 5,000 subscribers. So please go and subscribe so we can win this giveaway, okay? So anyway, she tagged me and a bunch of other YouTubers. So thank you so much, Amaya, for tagging me. It's kind of nice. It feels kind of nice to be tagged on YouTube, especially if you're a newbie, because you're like, oh my god, people know me. But anyway, I was planning to do a top 10 for the year. I still intend on doing that. Let me know if you want me to categorize it to strictly luxury items or if I could include other things, because there are some other things that I think are the best purchase of the year. Usually it's hard for me to do a regret because, or do any like worst items of the year, because usually when I purchase things, I'm quite sensible about it. Like I'm quite picky. My nature as well, like anything that I do buy, I'm quite picky with. So which is a good thing, because then I don't end up buying a lot of junk and, or things that I don't use. But it's kind of hard, and sometimes you do learn, like you do make some mistakes, or you think maybe I could have done without this item. Maybe that's something that I'll include. And I do have a few contenders for that, but I'm just going to pick one. So I'll do a separate video later. I'm curious to know, what are the top three luxury purchases that you've made this year, or even top one, it doesn't have to be top three. And what is something that you regret, if there is something that you regret? I'd like to know. Leave it in the comment section down below and we'll get started. So the first item on my list is the Burberry trench coat that I unboxed not too long ago. I purchased this on Louisa Via Roma, which they never released to keep Burberry on their site, but I noticed that they did this year, a little bit maybe last year as well. But I never thought they'd have more of the classic items on there, because as you know, Louisa Via Roma does do some sales. A lot of items don't qualify, but this did. And I was able to get this at 20% off in the initial stages. And it is the Chelsea trench coat, which is part of the Heritage line. And it's the longest length. They did have this is the extra long length, and then they have a long length. So with Burberry before, they used to have three lengths. With their classic trench coats, they had a shorter one, and then like the long, and then the extra long, and now they just have long and extra long. They also changed up their colors, so they no longer have the stone color, have another trench coat in that color. And they also changed the buttons, so the lighter, more camel color or honey color has beige buttons instead of the black horn buttons. And then the darker colors, they got rid of the black. And I was kind of surprised at that. Like, why would they get rid of black? And it came in the navy. And I was eyeing this coat before as well. Like, 2 years ago, I was eyeing getting a black coat. And they phased them out. They discontinued. I was considering purchasing this when I was traveling as well. And I was kind of not... I was on the fence about getting in navy. This is a very dark navy. At nighttime, it registers black, but I'm actually kind of glad I got the navy, because it's softer, it's not as harsh. You can wear it with black, you can wear it with other colors. It's a neutral and it goes with a lot of things. This has the Chelsea style has always been a very fitted style, and I never really considered it because I'm hippie, like I'm pear shaped, so a lot of things, like I have to be, they don't fit, right? Like I could be small up here, but they don't fit on the bottom. And this was a really tight fit, so I would always go with like the Kensington. The Sandringham style never fit me either because it was just way too narrow. And they actually restructured this style, so they went from runway to more practical style, so they added extra paneling, made it a little bit more generous across the chest and across the hips so it can fit average people, right? Anytime you get a Chelsea trench coat or this style, you always have to size up from your regular size in Burberry. So for instance, in my other trench coats, I am a UK 6, which is a US 4. And in the Chelsea, you have to go up a size. So I got a UK 8, US 6. And I was able to snag this because I tried it on before and I knew my size. And then when it went online, I just clicked, added to cart, ordered it. I saved about $800 on this, if I can't remember correctly. But I have this in the giveaway video as well. If you want to go check it out, the giveaway is still running until December 23rd, so go check it out. You can win a 6-ring Louis Vuitton key holder as well as some other prizes that I've stuck in there for the holidays because we're trying to brighten everybody's day, okay? So if you want to see me unbox this and try it on, I'll also insert mod shots here as well, but this is a good buy. I really, really do like this. I'm so glad I got this. This has more of like the vintage check on the inside, which is now part of their classic line. And yeah, I'm so glad I got the really long version because it's great for, it's very dressy. I've been wearing this a lot. So how I'm going to rate my top purchases is purchases that I started wearing right away and I started wearing more of. So this is perfect. It's actually quite warm. This is great for weather below, 15 degrees Celsius outside. I'll convert to Fahrenheit and insert it. But below 15 to, I would say, about 10 degrees or maybe 8 degrees. I don't know. Yeah, below 15 to 5 degrees. You can wear this if you have layers underneath. It is one of my best purchases. So the next item that is one of my top three is this Moncler, I guess, down. It's like a packable down. It's very lightweight parka, and it's really, really long. I unboxed this in one of my earlier videos back when I was still filming with my iPhone, so go if you want. I can insert the link in the description box. You can go check it out. One of my best purchases. I always had this item on my mind. Not particularly the style, but I always wanted like one of these sort of lightweight down jackets because in the winter time I usually wear my parka. I've had this. This is from a brand called Macaj, which is Canadian. You can order it internationally, I think, now too. You can order them online as well. But this is the Trish parka that I've had since, I want to say 2014. So I've had it for a really long time. They used to always be out of stock. I bought this in the summertime when Holt Renfrew stocked it. They called me and I was like, I'm there. Very, very good parka. Very heavy. Keeps me warm when it's really, really cold. I live in Toronto and it's cold. Okay. It gets cold in the wintertime. So you do need something that is going to keep you warm and dry. And this has been the best. However, even though in the last like 6 years, I would gravitate towards this, let's say from November to sometimes even like the first week of May. This year, first week of May, when we were all in lockdown, I was wearing this because it was cold and windy. And, but you know, sometimes it's not cold enough to wear this, right? Like I would always gravitate towards this because it's comfortable. It's, you know, water resistant. You know, it has a hood. It keeps my head warm. But there are times where you don't need such a heavy parka. And I recall even last year when we were still able to go to the malls and stuff like that, I would be wearing this and I would get overheated and it would felt heavy. And I just wanted something light. So yes, there's underground parking in malls, okay? So yeah, you can take your coat off and go inside, and we do that. But there are, you know, certain situations where you can't do that. Like, let's say if you're going to some of the flagship stores on Bloor Street, then, you know, you don't really have, you'd park underground somewhere, but you still have to walk outside and you do need the outerwear. So it would get a little bit too much. So I always thought, you know what, I want something that is water resistant, waterproof, well not waterproof, but water resistant, good for, you know, weather when you have a little bit of rain, but is not freezing yet. And that's why I picked this, okay? You do not need a luxury version of this, but I really liked it because it's very long, okay? The quilting is a little bit different. It's got the diamond quilting, so it's a little bit different. You've got zippered pockets, so things don't fall out. You also have a hood and drawstrings on it as well. Very lightweight. I liked how this is a bit of a matte finish. It's not so shiny. So I really don't like, I used to have a shiny Moncler jackets, but I'm kind of over that. So I wanted more of a matte finish. And it's got like a good amount of branding, okay? Because if you're wearing something this price, you want people to know. But I really, really like this. This is perfect for, you know, if it's 5 degrees Celsius to, let's say, minus three or something, okay? I'm just throwing an arbitrary number. But this is perfect for that because often you're going to have the little bit of the precipitation. You can put a sweater on underneath and you're good. It's sporty, it's easy to drive in. I was shoveling snow with this as well, so we had a few instances of snowfall. And sometimes when you're out there, you don't want to wear something so thick, like you want something waterproof, but you get overheated because you're also working out and shoveling. So I was wearing this, I was covered in snow, and when I got into the garage and I came into like the mudroom area, this was just kind of like the snow was just rolling off and this was dry. So I think this is a great purchase. You do not have to get the Moncler version. I'm telling you, I'm sure there are other brands that do this of equal quality, okay? This is, we're paying for logos here, okay? So there are other brands. I know Mocage has some really, really great ones as well, still at a higher price point, but there are other brands that do these. Aritzia has nice packable down jackets. Really, really good. I really like this jacket. And typically in the winter time, I don't really wear a lot of like my luxury items. It's hard because they get dirty, right? Like there's snow and there's salt everywhere, and with shoes and all that, I have to think about like what I'm wearing because I don't want to get them ruined. So it's nice that I have some flex available in the winter. The third item, you'll probably guess it, but it is Chanel Trendy CC in the 20A green from the Métier d'Art collection of this year. I'm not going to go on about this because I already posted a review, but this is an amazing bag. I'm so happy that I purchased this. It brings me such joy. I love this bag. I really love this bag. And I've done a review on this. There's also an unboxing. I'll link it in the description box if you want me, if you want to hear more of the pros and the cons, majority of pros of me raving about this bag. It goes with a lot of things. It looks dressy. It goes from day to night. Amazing bag. I really, really do love this. Check out the review below. And now for one of my regrets. I wouldn't really say this is my regret. It's just, it's one of the things I could have done without. And this is a pair of shoes. You'll be surprised. If you've watched my earlier videos, I'll link the unboxing for this. I have not worn these. I purchased this in the Chanel spring sale that they had and in like the early access sale. They're great shoes. They're tweed with leather. They've got a really good rubber sole, pointy toes. Everything about these are really nice. I just never wore them. And I was contemplating perhaps selling them. They do fit me. However, this comes up and it kind of hits the back of my ankle. They fit perfectly, but it's just this bit here. So I'm a little bit nervous that this might give me blisters, but they are leather, so they do accommodate your foot. I don't know. I haven't worn these, and I had other items. I had other shoes that I preferred to wear, so I didn't wear these. I'll let you know if I'm considering selling these or not, because I know a lot of people were looking for these once I unboxed them. But I'm a size 40, so these are a size 40, but you can probably get away wearing these if you're at 39 or 39 and a half. But I'm going to give these a chance, obviously not now because we're getting into winter, so you know, you don't want your foot so exposed because it's cold. And then also if there's snow and precipitation, I'm not ruining this. So this is probably going to be more of a spring shoe. So yeah, this could be one of the items that I could do without. Not necessarily a regret because it's a great item, but probably something I could have done without. If you followed me since I started this channel, there were quite a few epic purchases this year. And I don't shop that much normally, okay? This year was a bit different. I guess it was kind of my coping mechanism in a way. An unhealthy coping mechanism, but I guess we didn't have anywhere to go. Like, we weren't going anywhere. We obviously weren't going away. Other expenses that people would partake in that I don't. I mean, I don't drink. I don't smoke. So I don't have that sort of escapism. I guess that's not an excuse. But anyway, like, I don't spend money on that stuff, right? So, and, you know, this was, I happened to come across some really, really great items that I did have on my wish list. So that's why I was quick to grab them. So I usually have like a running list on my phone of, you know, items that I'm interested in purchasing or I do want to take a look at in person. So I group them by brand and I have it on my phone. I just type in something that I'm interested in. And when I say go into that particular store or shop, I'll look at that list of items and I'll see if, you know, if it's available, if I can take a look at it. And then I reevaluate if it's something that I really want. Most of the time I do know that that is something that I want, and once I see it, then, and if I have the funds available for it, then I'll bite the bullet and purchase it, and then I'll cross it off my list. And that list is always growing, so it's not good. Okay guys, so if you like this video, please consider giving it a like and subscribe if you haven't already. I'd really love to have you guys here. Thank you so much for spending this part of your day with me. I would really like to know what your luxury regrets are, what your top purchases were this year. It doesn't have to be, you know, actually it doesn't have to be luxury at all. It could be anything. What is your best purchase? Like, maybe it was like an espresso machine. I don't know. Let me know. Put it in the comment section down below. I'd really be interested to know. And stay tuned for more videos. I will see you next time. Bye.